New tonight, 24-hour News 8 sits down with several Delta Zeta members asked to leave their house at DePaul University. News 8's Marley Ginter joins us now. And Marley, what are they saying?
Debbie, some say it is a knock to their self-esteem, questioning whether or not they were kicked out because of their personal appearance. They say they're angry, confused, and above all, hurt.
Oh, here's all of us. We were all dressed up as Batman characters for philanthropy.
Celeste, Catherine, and Elizabeth laughed at old sorority photos. They used to live in the Delta Zeta house together. Celeste and Elizabeth were asked to leave. Catherine left on her own.
Was it about looks?
There's no proof of that, but when I look around, I think to myself that it had to have been.
They're not alone. 24-hour News 8 spoke to several girls interviewed by Delta Zeta's national officers. They say they were told to look their best.
And so many of my sisters had this happen to them, and they felt that they didn't have a choice.
This is a story getting national attention, from the New York Times to major networks to national magazines.
Does this reflect poorly on the university?
You know, I hope not.
Did the university have anything to do with it?
No. I mean, we did not determine that they would do a membership review in the manner that in which they did it.
Delta Zeta put out this statement. In the process of addressing that situation, we misjudged how some communications would be received by our members, and we regret that. Meantime, for girls like Celeste, Catherine, and Elizabeth, the sorority tie is broken, but perhaps their friendship is stronger.
Would you ever have joined?
No.
No?
None of us signed up for a sorority wanting to be judged on how we looked.
Delta Zeta says it will continue to work with DePaul University to resolve this issue. Meantime, it also released this statement. Delta Zeta finds it offensive that recent reports have suggested that decisions at DePaul University were related in any way to our members' races and nationalities. Marley Ginter, 24-hour News 8.